السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. بسم الله، الحمد لله، والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. This is your brother Muhannad Hakim Abu Salah al-Din, recording for the daily reminder. Today I will be talking about believers who are in mixed feelings between fear and hope from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We always have these different mixed feelings where you have hope in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His ultimate mercy, and you always think about His name, Ar-Rahman, Ar-Rahim, Al-Wadud, Al-Ghafur, that He's forgiving and merciful. At the same time, you read so many horrible ayat in the Quran about the punishment from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And believer, as Ibn al-Qayyim says, is like a bird flying with two wings, that of fear, and the other one is that of hope. And the head of that bird is love towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So you should have the two feelings at the same time. And it's wrong to have one feeling overcome the other, because you will be like that bird that is not balanced, that can crash and cannot continue the flight. Many people need to be reminded of the hope in Allah. At the same time, many should be aware that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has a very severe punishment. Allah says in the Quran,
نَبِّئْ عِبَادِي أَنِّي أَنَا الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ وَأَنَّ عَذَابِي هُوَ الْعَذَابُ الْأَلِيمُ.
Allah is telling His Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, tell my slaves that I am the forgiving, the merciful, but remind them that the punishment, my punishment, is a very painful punishment. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam visited a young man from the Sahaba, from the companions, who was on his deathbed, and he asked him, كيف تجدك? How do you feel your heart? And he said, أرجو الله وأخشى ذنوبي. He said, I have a lot of hope in the mercy of Allah, but I have a lot of fear from my sins, from my mistakes, from my shortcomings. And the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, ما اجتمع في قلب امرئ مؤمن في مثل هذه الساعة إلا غفر له. Whenever a believer on their deathbed have the same mixed feelings of fear and hope, Allah will forgive them. Meaning that you should maintain this feeling of mixed and hope until the last moment. Imam al-Ghazali has a very beautiful statement. He said, he was asked which one is better, fear or hope. And he said, this is not a very good question to ask, because it's like asking which is better for a human being, bread or water. You need both. If someone is hungry, they need bread, they need to eat, they need the carbs. And if someone is thirsty, they need the water. You need both fear and hope in your heart, and you have to be balanced, and you have to be smart in giving people the right doses of advice. Some people will need the advice of hope, others will need to be reminded with the punishment of Allah. Even Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu wa ardah, he used to be very wise in his nasiha. So whenever you're giving advice to a brother or a sister, you have to be smart. You have to use al-hikmah wal-maw'idha al-hasana, the right advice at the right time. One time a man comes to him and asks him, هل للقاتل توبة? If somebody is a killer, will Allah repent him? Will Allah accept his repentance? And he said, no, Allah will never forgive him. And in the same day, with the same gathering, another guy comes and asks, هل للقاتل توبة? Will Allah accept the repentance of a killer? And he said, yes, Allah will forgive any sin. And he was asked, how can you give two different answers for two different people? Ibn Abbas says, the first person, I saw killing in his eyes. He was intentionally going to kill someone, and he wanted to make sure that there's way back. The other person, I saw regret in his eyes. He was fearful. He committed maybe the act of killing, and he wanted to repent. So you should, as a da'iyah, as someone who's giving the advice at the right time, you should give balanced doses of fear and hope in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Brothers and sisters, let's maintain a balanced feeling of fear and hope in our heart, and let's use that hikmah, that wisdom, when we give advice to people. Jazakumullahu khairan. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.